were going to the hospital at a community called Kipata, Katika. There's a well. It's up on a hill. The pump has fallen to the bottom of the well. We're going to see if we can snag this pump and bring it out.
I work with the medical coordination of the Baptist community here in Congo, and this hospital at Kipata, Katika is one of our hospitals. My husband, Wayne, has been collaborating with a group of Congolese engineers in order to get water to this hospital and also to the surrounding community.
In America, you would have an enormous crane doing all that.
This is the Vanga Evangelical Hospital in rural Congo. It serves a population of more than 250,000 people, and because of the level of care here, patients come from a long way away to get treatment at this hospital.
Eh, boy, mama. Tu bien guérir avec la grâce de Dieu, malembe, malembe, hein? She had injury during childbirth, and she lost her child. She was abandoned by her husband. Not only do we help her heal physically, but we also want to heal the brokenness of the soul, telling her the good news of Jesus as she sees other women with similar problems that are being healed and being encouraged.
Okay, ça va? Numéro 5.
Currently, I am teaching the children of our doctors. When their children arrive at the age of going to school, they will move back to the capital, Kinshasa, because that's where the higher quality schools are. We want to retain our most experienced doctors so that they can be training the next generation of doctors to help give them an option for quality education.
The legacy of my parents' work, Dr. Dan and Miriam Fountain, they left behind them a whole health infrastructure in Congo. Less in terms of cement and roofing tiles, much more in terms of the people that they trained up and worked with. The buildings can be destroyed by a windstorm, but the people that you leave behind, whose lives have been impacted by your ministry, are what it's all about.